Hello YouTube, how you doing earthlings? Welcome to another Trapdoor Sculptures video series video. Part 14. And I've got very little done, to be honest. I don't quite know where all the time's gone. A lot of it was making bonies and then mending Berk's arm and painting him. But I've finished Berk now. Here we are. I'm going to show you what I've done. There's my stuff so far. That was my clay bony that I'd done that I just abandoned really early on. This was my plasticine bony. It wasn't quite correct, and the only bit of white plasticine I've got, so I've been nicking little bits off him. And I've been making some of the little creatures that inhabit the trapdoor universe. Some worms and some little creepy crawly things. And this is my Drutt so far. As you can see, he's got no legs yet. I've ordered some pipe cleaners off eBay after watching the fantastic videos from James Wilde on the trapdoor universe. I do recommend you check out all his videos. They are really, really good. He gets tons of views, so I don't really think he needs any help, but anyway, I endorse his build quality, and his artistry is just, you know, up there with the top, the best. And he can afford to buy decent amounts of plasticine as well, which is always handy. I've got a very small supply, but anyway. Have to silence my video that's playing on the background. Sorry. I just play through them to make sure there's no problems. But anyway, yeah. So, as you can see, I've actually done a bit of alterations to Boni. Sorry, Drutt. I thought he had a kind of, you know, where they do the corners of the mouth kind of. That sort of shape, and I thought this bit was a corner of the mouth, but it's actually a part of his mouth that just goes down and up. But I've filled it, but I haven't filled it very well, so I'm not very happy with that, to be honest. I've just noticed that there's a little divot here as well. As you can tell, he's a different colour now to what he was before. I had a look on, I just typed in what colour is Drutt, and it came up immediately in the trapdoor wiki. Drutt is olive green. Well, he always looked grey to me, so I did have I have this Tamiya olive drab, lovely paint, very expensive, too expensive for me these days. So I just mixed that sort of 70-30 and 30% of some grey, the same grey that I've been using for my Totoro sculptures, and it's just a, you know, sort of a grey. So, and he still looks grey to me, but I am red-green colourblind, so. But he does look quite a lot like he does on the series, the trapdoor. So, what I'm going to attempt to do now is, you can see I've painted a little bit of the olive in his mouth. Oops. And now I want to kind of try and finalise his mouth while I'm, well, I say finalise, all I'm going to be doing probably is a bit of black inside his mouth, and then hopefully if I've got the right colour plasticine, give him a little red tongue, because that's about the only red you can see in his mouth. And then he's going to have, well, I need some black, not white. That's the complete opposite end of the spectrum. I'm getting quite near to completing a lot of my sculptures, and I've actually finished a Hulk sculpt miniature sort of sculpture, and I'm going to be doing a video of that. And I'm doing a scratch built spaceship as well at the moment from junk. I'm doing my Totoro figures, three of them, but are now four. I've got what else am I doing? I'm building some scratch built robots. I've got a Cindy doll that's becoming a robot doll, robot space fantasy, whatever. So I'm just painting a bit of black in there, really. That's all I'm doing. What else am I doing? I started a Big Hero 6 sculpture, but that's about as far as that got. I've got a project I've got to do for my mum for Christmas sculpture. So yeah, as soon as I finish my Totoro ones, oh, my morph ones as well, my morph sculptures are coming on. I've only really got to can you actually see what I'm doing here? You can. I'm going to turn the camera down a little bit. There we are. Yeah, I'm just putting a bit of black inside his mouth very, very carefully. Dabbing my brush in a bit of water as well. Not the hugest amount of light today. Winter is coming, as they say in that TV series that we all know and love very much. I want to watch again. Even though the last season was a bit naff. Game of Thrones, of course, is what I'm talking about. Yeah, I was kind of doing a Game of Thrones Drogon sculpture. I will be revisiting it. Right, this is becoming really quite difficult to get into that. Just going from the front here, then remove anything I don't want. Yeah, one more tiny little bit up there. Excellent, I'm pleased with that. And also, Drutt, he's kind of Boni's sort of puppy dog that he doesn't really treat very well. But he's, Drutt, suddenly appears with four younglings, young Drutts, called the Nibblers. Or Nippers, his Nippers, Drutt's Nippers, or Drutt's Nibblers, I think is the more correct term. But, so they're going to be smaller than him. I'm hoping that my pipe, I've ordered pipe cleaners off eBay, I'm hoping they're going to be small enough so when I trim them down, I can do Drutt's legs. But then I'm going to have to do legs for even smaller. His little nibblers, which are all sort of pinks and purples, I think. I'm going to pause this video because I want to. Auto collection. Right, yeah, come on. Shush. Pause. Alright. Right, plasticine. I've been trying to be a bit more careful with my plasticine recently, so these are all my mixed rubbishy bits that I can make loads of my other little squidgy wormy things and whatever. This is my tiny little bit of white that I have. Some pink. I ran out of little bags to put them in, so hopefully I might have enough pinks here to be able to do Drutt's nibblers. And there's some black and some blues. Nice colours there. And these are the original plasticine. I don't think I've got a red. I don't, by the looks, oh, there we are, got a red there. Yeah, so I've been putting them in little bags and making sure they stay nice and clean and apart, away from each other. So yeah, is this red going to be good enough for his tongue? Where's my picture gone? Because even though it looks red there, it goes really quite pinky when, no, I think I'm going to make that out of, gonna be tiny, whatever I do. What colour I could mix? Is that gonna be? The right sort of contrast? Yeah, I think it's the right colour of red. Gonna do it. Just do it and see how it looks. I suppose I've got any red in here, haven't I? This pile of garbage. What's that colour? See, once, is that brown or red? I can't tell. I think that's brown. It's horrible and dirty anyway, whatever it is. But anyway, I'm gonna quickly make a little worm, one of these little wormies to that, what colour have I got there? Just do a, purple worm. Do you know why we say, let's do a purple worm? Because you're not actually doing it at all, it's me. Right, so, get my plasticine nicely squidgified up. Can you see what I'm doing? Get it nice and clean on the outside, give it a good few kneads, and it also softens the plasticine a bit. So I'm gonna do this quick little worm demo. So you can make all your own little worms. So I just roll it out. Always make it longer than what I think, because it always end up running out of worminess when I'm sort of animating them or putting them in their final form. I don't know how this one's going to work out yet. Coil worm, and look, I download. Excellent. I'll just do an impression of a mouth, not actually. He always needs some eyeballs. So I'm gonna dig out a bit of nice. No, I've got that other bit, haven't I? This bit of white. I really am working on micro scale with these. I wish I'd made them all bigger. Sorry, a bit of a wonky eyeball there. I wish I'd made them all bigger. And I can feel in my fingers whether they're about the right size. Fingers are very, very good at recognising sizes and shapes. Oh, beautiful down there. Come out. Pupils, let me put that back in this bag. James says, if you feel you've messed up, just do them again. So, drut, tongue. I'm actually going to try and make it sort of tongue looking, so kind of have a little going to be too big. It's too big. Well, not too big, just too long. So I'll take some of that off. Get another go. It in the wrong way. Now I've got some muckiness over it. I need a clean tool. I've got clay all over my tools. I think that this isn't sticking in there properly because it's too mattiness in there. I've had this, keep on getting this problem. Trying to insert clay into. So what I think I'm going to do
Podge at the back there. Yeah, that's not worked. It has stuck in there, but it's the wrong shape and size now. And it's got some bit of dodginess on there, so I'm going to have to knead it again. Tiny little bit of clay, plasticine. Take up quite a bit of his mouth. Yeah, not quite that much. How long have I been doing this for? 20 minutes. And I've made a worm. Oh, painted the inside of Drutt's mouth as well. Oh, he didn't go on the floor. If at first you don't succeed, try and try again. And I really am very trying. Call that a Drutt tongue, because it's in about exactly the right place. I'm going to have to move it over a little bit. I think it's the right colour. Now all I have to do is fit a tiny little tooth in there, or two teeth. I think it's two teeth. And I'm going to do that when I get the pipe cleaners, because this is already a long video. Long enough. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave a little like and a comment, please. That would be very much appreciated. And I'll see you in the next one. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and goodbye.